So in this study, what we've been able to do for the very first time is to make tumors very sensitive to radiation by using ultrasound and microbubbles to perturb, in some manner, the blood vessels that are inside the tumor. And this probably results of the fact that these blood vessels are very sensitive to biomechanical perturbation, and by using ultrasound with these microbubbles, we've been able to stimulate various gene pathways inside these blood vessels. That when we follow that sort of treatment with a small dose of radiation that's on its own does not do very much, it results in 50 to 60% of tumor cell death 24 hours after the treatment is given. The significance of this is that normally patients need to receive 35 of those small radiation treatments to cure a tumor, yet here with just one of those 35 treatments, we're able to destroy 50 to 60% of the tumor by using these ultrasound-stimulated microbubbles in advance of the radiation. So the work which is about to be published was conducted preclinically in tumor models, and it shows strong promise in that we should be able to translate it very quickly into patients with large tumors where they need many doses of radiation to treat these tumors. We have done the work that's been published in prostate cancer models, and there are publications which will soon be out as well showing that the methodology works as well in bladder tumors and in breast tumors, and the goal is to conduct first-in-human studies in the next 12 to 18 months using MRI guidance on a new MRI ultrasound therapy suite here at the ODEC Cancer Center at Sunnybrook.